Take one.
I'm Joanna Dabaj. I'm co-founder and principal coordinator at Catalytic Action.
And I'm Ricardo Conti, executive director at Catalytic Action. So basically, the idea was that like we started Catalytic Action because we met in London. We're like three people from different countries, slightly different background. We all studied architecture, but coming from different universities. It was me, Joanna from Lebanon, and Laura from UK. I'm from Italy. And we were doing this master's in London that was focusing on architecture and development. So a slightly different focus of architecture, more dealing with the people, community, participation, etc. And so when we finished the master's, we wanted to apply these notions to the practice.
We looked for the first opportunities in Lebanon. That's a country that is hosting a large number of refugees, making like one out of four people in Lebanon a refugee. So when we started to do like some analysis and understanding the refugee crisis, like of course affected by the Syrian conflict, and we found out that the children are one of the most vulnerable groups in the society. And our pilot project consisted of designing and implementing a playground project. But the project doesn't just happen just like by deciding to do something. So there was a research background that we carry out, let's say from London, desktop research. And then we go and start to do participatory exercises with the children and with the community to understand more the needs and the struggles that they face. And this happens when we are there on site, in Lebanon in this case. And we did also exercises with the children where we asked them about their ideal playground space and where they draw it or they do a collage. And then it's a series of exercises where it's a kind of a research, but at the same time where you're asking the beneficiary to tell you about what he needs, you know? And when you're in a place for a period of time, you need a house, you need a shelter, but you also need to live on everyday basis, eat, make friendships, and you know, like try to survive on an everyday basis, and then also try to escape and try to exit like France and go to the UK, but also as a group. So these dynamics makes you really think about what's happening like now in this world that we're living in, and it's very different than what's happening in Lebanon.
What we're trying to do basically is just like to provide like a normal life in a way, a normal life to the kids that are at the moment living in Lebanon, hoping that one day they will go back to Syria and they will be able to just keep on having that normal life. So getting an education, getting same child development, so having the right to play, having the right to go to school and not have to work at the age of 12 or I don't know what. So that's what we're trying to do. It's not like we want to provide I don't know, like huge projects. It's like small interventions that can just provide this normal life to these kids.